nasty finish here, and this finally will end the match.
Yeah. Magnus was probing for weaknesses on the king side, but it comes to an end with a loss for Magnus, an interesting one, because he still wins the match despite a very, very strange day, and ultimately a match that went on longer than we predicted it possibly could have. But Magnus Carlsen defeats Hans Niemann by a final score of 17.5 to 12.5, and he will play in another Speed Chess Championship final.
And unlike others, he will not be playing Hikaru Nakamura in the final. We have a new face, a new finalist, and Magnus Carlsen, world number one, just took down Hans Niemann, a player who is maybe one of the best-known players on the planet for some things off the board. But here, his play on the board, it was inspired at times, but it wasn't quite enough. He didn't have the collective package. And Magnus Carlsen, he made him pay. Even after blundering, he still got some wins in. So Magnus, he really made his mark here. He's still in this. He will be in the final on Sunday.
And regardless of how he got there, the ups and downs, the weirdness of the event, of the match, of the of whatever it was leading into it, Magnus has got to be breathing a sigh of relief. He beats Hans Niemann. And whatever he thinks that means and whatever statements that sends, the truth is this match was not even as close as the final score, Robert. That's the truth. Magnus Carlsen dominated this match and sent whatever message could be sent.
I think at some point he was up by 10 games in the match. It ends up being 5 when the match was out of hand. But either way, we know our title match. Magnus Carlsen, Ali Reza Faruja, Hans Niemann. He's still alive. He gets to play against Hikaru Nakamura. But it wasn't his day against the best player in the world.
And we'll see how Hans recovers for that match with Hikaru Nakamura. That is a big match, as we said, with all kinds of big feelings. And there's a lot of tensions there between those two guys.